The Voron Zero is one of the most anticipated do-it-yourself printers. It is compact, it is fast, and meanwhile there are kits in order to avoid self-sourcing. A lot of viewers asked, which kit should I get? I built and tested the LDO and Formbot kit in order to answer that question. Join me for the review video part 1. We have a detailed look at the components of each kit, check the build experience, and we will see if do-it-yourself is ready for plug-and-play. Right here at 24/7 Printing. Do-it-yourself printer concepts by Voron and RatRig became more and more popular recently. These printers are a huge step forward concerning printing speed while remaining print quality. RatRig provides kits as a company. Voron focuses on providing well-engineered open-source 3D printer designs originally meant for self-sourcing. Due to the popularity of the legendary Voron 2.4 and the small-scale Voron Zero, there are many offers for kits arising. Formbot has offers for every single Voron printer right now, and LDO is offering Voron Zero, Voron 2.4 and Voron Switchwire kits. After having some deep experiences with an early Voron Zero kit from Formbot, I wanted to know how good and convenient are those kits meanwhile, what are their main differences, and are they viable for building a well-operating next-generation printer? Let's check it out! For the Formbot kit, there are mainly two sources. It's on and off on AliExpress, and you can order their kits on their own website. One general fact to point out is, you can choose between three hot ends. The price for the Dragon High Flow variant, which I chose, is around 450 euros or $500. Be aware, this is eventually plus shipping and taxes. LEO has a big variety of resellers all over the world and offers a listing on their dedicated Voron kits documentation. You find a link in the video description. There are no options available, you always get a Fadus Dragonfly hot end. Prices are around $650 in US or 680 euros in Europe. A short disclaimer here, the LDO kit was provided free of charge by LDO Motors and Caribou 3D for reviewing purposes. I had to pay for the shipping from China. The Formbot kit was paid with my own money. These general conditions do not influence my opinions in any respect. Formbot packages the components quite loosely. And LDO adds a lot more boxes in order to organize the components in clusters. This adds quite a bit more of cardboard waste. In addition to that, I personally would have appreciated the Prusa kit way. Clustering the parts according to the build steps in the manual and not according to general technical clusters. While building, I personally want to have an overview of all parts, so I unpacked every box anyways. That may be my personal taste, but summing up, both kits are well packed and you'll find everything you need in order to build a Voron 0.1. Almost, but we'll see later. Before getting started with the build, you have to 3D print the parts for the assembly. Voron specifies the material and settings in order to assure flawless operation. This might be one of the biggest hurdles for the average user beforehand, as it is recommended to print the parts from ABS, which demands high print temperatures and in most cases an enclosed build space. I chose Essence ABS Plus, which is close to the properties of regular ABS, but prints a lot easier. I printed some of the parts on my Prusa Mark III, but most of them on my RatRig Vcore 3. Both are unenclosed and had no problems with warping or other issues printing at 250 degrees Celsius for the hot end and 110 degrees Celsius for the print bed. Just make sure your print surface is absolutely clean and properly leveled. For the linear rails and the lead screw motors, you need lubricants, and they are not included in both kits. I use EP2 for the lead screws and WD-40 Specialist PTFE for the linear rails, as there is less friction and practically no maintenance necessary. Also check out Nero's dedicated video explaining the lubrication topic. Make sure to clean the rails in IPA for some hours while moving them from time to time before lubrication. Besides the label, I was not able to spot any difference between the linear rails of both kits. and I strongly assume the only difference is the labeling, as they both have the typical play and look the same in general. I want to do further investigation on this topic, so please tell me your thoughts in the comments. When building the LDO kit, you don't need to populate the nut carriers with M2 nuts. You just use the provided steel carriers, which is a bit more convenient, but it's weight on the gantry. So maybe use the default nut carriers for the X-axis if you plan to speed up your machine, as every gram counts for speed at quality printing. Concerning the mechanical assembly of the frame and print bed carrier, there is practically no difference between the two kits. The aluminium extrusions of both kits are straight and prepared correctly. There are some flaws on the Formbot extrusions, but you normally won't spot this if not using a macro lens in order to make some photos. Using a precision milled aluminium plate, I had no problem to build both frames square and aligned. You'll find other suggestions in the build manual. The fastness differ in material and color. Stainless steel at Formbot versus burnished black steel at LDO. In my opinion, it's a matter of taste. Another difference comes up concerning the motors. LDO of course includes their own ones, and in the Formbot kit I received motors by Ukeda. I never really heard of or used them before, but concerning the general specifications, they're up to the demands of the printer, as they appear to be clones of the OMC steppers specified in the Voron sourcing guide. I'll come back to this in the next video, when I'll do the performance check for both printers. A nice touch for the LDO kit, grub screws come with screw lock pre-applied, like specified in the build manual. That's handy, but you'll need additional screw lock for both kits anyways, as you should also apply to the screws for the bed mounts. And a short note to the bearings for the motion system. Both are practically the same. I was not able to spot any difference. For the lead screws of the Z-axis, stainless steel on Formbot and burnished black on LDO. Concerning the functionality, there's hardly any difference to expect. Matter of taste again, in my opinion. During the build, you have to preload a lot of M3 nuts into the slots of the extrusions in order to position them for mounting parts on the frame. In their dedicated documentation, LDO recommends a very handy user mod which carries square nuts or hex nuts in order to hold their position. LDO is also providing additional square nuts in order to use them with the mod. A little tip, because I stumbled over this, align the preloaded nuts of the bed carrier before you mount the holders of the linear rails for the Z-axis. Concerning the rest of the motion system, genuine gates belts for both, but 1 meter more in the LDO kit. This is really handy, as you need around 2 meters for the build. That means you'll have a set of spare ones. A quite big difference is the pre-built print bed coming with the LDO kit. The heater is additionally attached with silicone gasket marker, which might help for safety, but smelled like hell for the first 10 days, and with me being very sensitive to industrial fumes, I suffered from quite hefty allergic reactions when being in the same room. That might be an individual case, but worth mentioning in my opinion. So you need to attach the heater and thermal fuse on your own when building a Formbot kit. This also implies soldering. But if you know what you're doing, this can be done very quickly in 15 to 30 minutes. No big deal, but yeah, it's some additional time, soldering and accessory like heat shrink sleeves you need. Both build plates are very nicely machined, and from first printing test there were no problems concerning a nice and even first layer. Another nice touch on the LDO side, they additionally provide a smooth PEI spring steel build surface with their kits, and the textured one is double-sided. Really cool, as those are quite expensive even on AliExpress. Formbot gives you one single-sided textured one, which also works very well. Concerning the hot ends, LDO provides a complete retail product of the Fatus Dragonfly, also containing the tools and additional fasteners packed in a nice box. Formbot provides a bulk Dragon high flow without box or accessory. Not a big deal, but it feels reduced in comparison to the older kit, where you got the full retail package and the accessory might come handy for a lot of users. The Moon's extruder motor on the Formbot side is well known and established. A little bit heavy for high-end speed printing, but in general a good choice. I don't really know the tiny LDO extrusion motor, but LDO per se is known for good quality motors. We will check out the extrusion combinations in the next video, comparing different materials and their extrusion flows. The general question also will be, do you really need high flow hot ends in a stock Voron Zero doing casual but fast printing? We will find out. LDO provides genuine Bontech parts for the drivetrain of the extruder. Formbot gives you a no-name clone drive kit, just like in the old Voron 0.0 kit I got last year, which I didn't use because I went for a Hemerite Bowden. Checking out the extruder gears closely, it becomes clear. The manufacturing quality of the Bontech gears from the LDO kit is definitely top-notch. Concerning the surfaces, the gears delivered on the actual Formbot Voron 0.1 kit look even smoother. Though geometry is slightly varied in comparison to the original. Same impression for the Formbot 0.0 kit. I assume they use an additional but quite short tumbler deburring process, which might correct eventual manufacturing flaws. Comparing the maybe cheapest BMG clones I have laying around, this additional process might not have been applied here. You can clearly see the flaws caused by fast and inaccurate production. Though, I have been using those on some of my printers without problems over years now. LDO provides genuine GDS time and Sunon fans like recommended in the Voron sourcing guide. They are known for good quality and performance. They come completely prepared and labeled for plug and play. Formbot delivers, at least to me, unknown size shoe fans of which you have to make the parallel cable connection by yourself. You also have to lengthen the wires for the heatsink fan. I used the provided wires from the kit, but I had to use my own heat shrink tubes and solder connectors. We'll have a look at the cooling performances in the next video. Time to talk about wiring, which marked the biggest difference for my build experience. Proper wiring is important for reliable operation and safety. Also, it's one of the last steps of the build before operation. I am definitely able to make quite proper wirings, but I'm also impatient, always short on time, and I don't like the fiddling very much. So, I was very curious about how much plug and play we get with the advertised pre-made wiring looms of both kits. The wiring of the LDO kit was straightforward, and I can keep it short, except for the wires of the motors, every single wiring loom is prepared concerning length and connectors. In addition to that, they are nicely labeled. The length of the wires are not perfect, but LDO provides a wiring duct which you have to cut to length by yourself in order to clean up the resulting wiring mess. That's also the only component I have to criticize. It appears quite fragile, and in my case, the outlets are kind of sharp-edged. LDO also provides an additional manual for the wiring, where the whole process is explained. This was helpful, and without rushing really, taking some photos and hacksawing the wiring duct to length, I was able to finish the whole wiring in 1 hour and 45 minutes. That comes quite close to plug and play in my opinion. The Formbot kit also comes with some pre-made wires, including mains wires, all end stops, 24-volt wiring and 5-volt wiring. They come unlabeled, but you'll find the designation on the bags. So, I labeled those on my own, which took around 7 minutes. Not really a big deal. Concerning the tool head and the print bed wires, the lengthening and crimping is meant to be done by yourself. Formbot gives you almost everything you need for this, including JST-SM connectors in order to make interfacings here and there. For example, for the tool head. As there are no ducts or similar provided, I also recommend to lengthen and recrimp the motor wires in order to manage the wiring mess. Adhesive sockets like those I used would have been handy to make the routing clean, and they add reliability. In my case, both of the 24-volt pre-made wires were too short, so I also had to prepare those for myself. Formbot also includes some fork spade terminals, but unfortunately the amount of those was not sufficient. I also did not use the provided closed cable sleeve for the tool head, as it is quite narrow and in my opinion it would have been too much hassle to thread the wires through. Just provide open ones, like in the LDO kit. They should not be much more expensive and add a lot of value for the builder. Having all the tools and accessory needed for the wiring actions at hand, I finished the complete wiring for the Formbot kit in 3.5 hours. When recapping and comparing to my first Formbot Voron Zero build from last year, the actual Formbot 0.1 kit definitely is a leap forward. Though there is still some room for quite easy to do improvements for Formbot. And this leads me directly to the verdict of the overall build experience for the Formbot and LDO kit. To express it in one sentence, Both kits are viable for building a well-operating Voron Zero, and there are absolutely no severe flaws or downsides for both kits. Spoiler for the performance video, both kits are also printing nicely, but there are some differences concerning performance here and there. LEO provides conveniences in order to keep hassle away and to save build time. Concerning the overall build experience and the provided components, there is not really much to criticize. In addition, LEO offers helpful additional documentation and has a dealer network all over the planet. That goes along with a comparably high price tag though, and there are only pre-configured kits. There are no options for the hotend, so you're forced to the Fatus Dragonfly, which might be sufficient for most users though. You change money for time when going for the LEO kit, and you definitely have a more convenient build experience. The LEO kit comes quite close to plug and play like a Prusa kit. The Formbot kit is a money saver for tinkerers, but you'll need additional time, efforts, tools and accessory. The wiring processes involved mark the most noticeable difference, and not all parts appear to be well chosen. For example, the fans for the part cooling or the cable sleeving for the tool head. Also, it's a pity that some pre-crimped wires were useless in my case and that there is nothing included for cable guiding. So, if you like to do the wiring for yourself anyways, you can definitely go for the Formbot kit. When ordering directly at Formbot from China, you can also talk to their service about leaving out some parts from the kit in order to source your choices by yourself. If you want the best of the best for your Voron Zero, you should go for self-sourcing anyways. For example, you might obtain higher quality linear rails or other hot ends. The build of the LEO kit took around 13 hours, and I've done the build of the Formbot kit in around 16 hours, including documentation and camera work. So which kit would you choose and why? Please tell me in the comments, I'm curious. Thank you so much for watching, liking, commenting, subscribing and sharing this video on social media. See you in the next one, right here on 24/7 Printing. D for reviewing purposes. Voron specifies, Formbot delivers. Every single. I also did not use the overall experience. You're forced to the Dragonfly in your rails for the fast and integrated production. In addition to that, and in my case,